Hey everybody, good to well, I guess I can't see or I can hear you though. Good to be back doing the commentary. I was cleaning my room up a little bit ago, and I was putting my I have like a snowball mic that I've used for a while. I put that back in, and it kind of came loose, and for some reason I think the legs got that little hole that the legs go in. I think it got stripped, so. Hopefully you'll be able to hear the microphone okay, but I kind of wanted to do a video on the Ravager, specifically in regards to comparing the casual version of the Ravager to the juicy Ravager. Before I had found a well, I had had a just a casual Ravager, and had the, you know, he had the tour grip and everything else like that. So I went ahead and just went with that for a while, but I think I can't even remember where I found it at. But one day I found a really nice looking juicy Ravager. It had really good stats on it, and so I picked it up and started using it. I wondered how it would compare to the casual. So I thought I would just kind of make a video about it. I don't really think it's it's definitely not a you should use this, you should use that. Nothing like that. It's just kind of to see what they're both capable of. They both have the drawbacks and their pros, I guess you can say. The casual version has a lot of power. I mean, I honestly don't think you could get any more power than say with a casual version, because it has the two extra pellets on it, I believe. I think it's 18 pellets. So it's really powerful, and you can use that to great extent. But the one of the downsides is you can see there the accuracy is very, very low. So you're gonna have to either be either point blank or in close range to be able to get a lot of the pellets to hit. For the juicy Ravager, I was noticing that it actually has a little better accuracy. It was kind of surprising too, because I believe the accuracy is in like the 20 or 30 range, and so you can really use it a little bit more at distance than say the casual version, which was kind of cool. For the enemies I've tested the juicy with, it's kind of weird. Some of them will take really, really good damage, and I mean, if you didn't know, I probably should back up a little bit. The casual prefix of the Ravager is the damage, whereas the juicy prefix is the critical hit damage. So with the casual version, like I said, you're getting 18 pellets, but with the juicy version, you're only getting 16 pellets, but you gain an extra 50% critical damage. So I kind of wondered how that would work out. And with the way the Ravager is, it's not really like, say, probably the Sword Explosion would be a good example. The casual Sword Explosion has a times 3, the 3 pellets, but any other version is just the 1 pellet. And if you think about it that way, you're losing out on quite a bit of damage by not picking up the casual version. But for the Ravager, you already have a ton of pellets. I mean, you're having at least 16 pellets, and the casual version is only adding 2 more pellets. So really, if you the way I thought about it is that I'm not really losing a whole lot to get the extra critical damage. So anyway, that's why I wanted to try to come and test. And I know, as you can see, I'm in my levels I always find myself in testing these things, and it's the forest from the Tiny Tina DLC. So I thought it would be a good way just to see what each one is capable of. For some enemies, like the tree ants that have a lot of health, you can kind of see just how much damage both Ravagers do. Actually, they do a considerable amount of damage. And I don't know if I've showed it yet, but I think I show the juicy version here in a minute. That's the one I usually go with now. I've sort of put my casual version in the bank for right now, because I just feel that the juicy version does a lot of damage. And the drawback to that one, I guess, would be if you don't really hit all the criticals, or if you're not really getting a good shot on it, you might miss some on damage. Wow, yeah, the accuracy on that is, it went from like 7 for the casual one to 26 for the juicy one, so it's definitely an increase in accuracy, which is kind of nice. As you can see, it really does a lot of damage when you're up close, but then again, both of them do. So that's my whole premise on just going through here to see. After the video here, it's just kind of, I'm just going to stick with the juicy for now, because there isn't really, in my opinion and in my view, there really isn't a whole lot of a big difference between the damage between the two. So, and anyway, I really love the sword explosion for the shotgun. I think it's probably the best explosive shotgun for him. Other people would probably argue that the Ravager is higher damage or DPS or whatever they want to say, but with the Ravager, you're kind of stuck with being closer range. And granted, you're not really supposed to be in close range for the sword explosion, but you can use the sword explosion. It's really effective at, say, mid range, but I mean, if you get used to how it spreads, you can also use it for longer ranges too. That's why I feel that it's a little better than the Ravager, because I rarely find myself using the Ravager unless I just want to mix things up for a while. But it's kind of interesting how these different shotguns work. And interestingly enough for me, whenever I seem to pick up ammo for these guns, it's always seems to be fairly generous with the shotgun ammo for some reason. I'm not sure. I'm not even sure if that's the case or if I'm just kind of assuming that every time. But it always seems that there's a plentiful amount of shotgun ammo, which is kind of nice, because I think there's some super super powerful shotguns like the ones I've mentioned. And, the elemental versions that come to mind there, of course, are the Omens. Those are beastly shotguns. I mean, I should say that is a beastly kind of shotgun. You can see there, it just does a lot of damage, but I would tend to think that, I think of the best explosive one for Axton would be the Sword Explosion. You have a couple options for elemental and for explosive, too. This is just my opinion, but for elemental, I would probably go with the Omen. Granted, you have ones like the Interfacer, but that just like burns through ammo. It's just kind of like the Lyuta. They're both great weapons, but it's kind of a buzzkill when you run out of ammo like a minute after you start shooting. But yeah, I love shotguns are really cool in this game. I was kind of surprised to hear some people saying that TDR shotguns lack punch of any kind, and I was like, they are very effective. The cool thing about that, I know I'm kind of getting on a Omen rant here, but the cool thing about the Omen is you can use it up front, which to great effect, but you can also use the sweet spot to where the pellets all converge in one very straight and narrow pattern. And that does incredible damage too. So I guess what I'm saying is, I got off kind of a tangent there, but yeah, shotguns are, if you're an explosive Axton, or just you're gonna be an elemental Axton too, but you're gonna really love the shotgun choices. And there's lots of other good weapon types too. Assault rifles, which, yes, of course, they don't suck. You just gotta find the right setup for it and you'll be good to go. And of course, pistols and everything else. So, just let me know what you think. When I'm talking about shotguns, I did. I think a long time ago, I I reset the playthrough to try to get a new sword explosion. Well, it's been so long. I don't know if it was a reset to get it or if I just wanted to get a better one, but I think this the one I have now is the first one that actually came up with had the casual prefix on it, which was really cool because it had the Hyperion. I think it has the Hyperion stock on it. And then, of course, the Tor grip, but it had the teeter sight, which, I mean, that's small things for that. And I don't really have a problem with the TDR sight. It looks pretty cool. So, but yeah, I really enjoy using shotguns like that. What I was also gonna say was I was thinking about trying out what were they called? The ones in the Jolly Roger from the Scarlet DLC. I think that's another one that has a bunch of pellets on it. That'd be kind of cool, though. I've been thinking that'd be kind of cool to get my hands on and see. But if I wanted to do that, I'd have to either trade for it or just start a new playthrough. So I'm debating on whether to do that or not. So I guess I'll know here in a little bit. I had taken quite a bit of time off to kind of make Borderlands a little bit fresher and newer for me. So I did a pretty quick run through of Resident Evil 4 because I had that on my hard drive. That took me like 3 or 4 days. That was kind of fun. And then this video here was kind of, I had kind of recorded a while back, but and I'm just now adding commentary to it. But at the time of this recording here, at the time of my commentary, I had been playing the first Transformers game. That's kind of fun, the War for Cybertron. So it's kind of nice to step away for a little bit and just come back to it fresh. I actually was playing it the other night and just going through Sawtooth again, kind of trying to go through that beast of a place. So, but anyway, just let me know what you think about the casual versus juicy prefix, and it's kind of cool to get back and doing this again. And hopefully, I'll be able to have some more videos loaded up for too long, and I hope you guys will take care, and so I will see you in the next video sometime. Alright, take care, fellas. Ladies, bye.
front of it!
You fellas meet the missus?
Yeah.
go.